So it's important to understand these two concepts of latency and throughput. Latency is the elapsed time for an event. If it takes me 1 minute to walk from my office to the classroom, that's the latency that I'm going to experience for that event of walking from my office to the classroom. That's the elapsed time. Throughput is the number of events that can be executed per unit time. Bandwidth is a measure of throughput. So once again, with this analogy of walking to the classroom from my office, if the hallway is wide enough to allow 5, 10 of us to walk in parallel, side by side, to the classroom, increases the throughput, but it does nothing to the latency. The latency is going to be determined by how fast I can walk from my office to the classroom. So the difference between latency and throughput is very important to understand. In other words, I can increase the bandwidth, and that will improve the throughput, but it is not going to do anything to the latency itself. So in other words, higher bandwidth does not necessarily imply lower latency. You have to work hard to lower the latency. RPC is the basis for client-server-based distributed systems, and performance of RPC is crucial. Specifically, in the context of this lesson, latency refers to the time it takes for an application-generated message to reach its destination. So for instance, if you're doing an RPC call from a client to the server, then the RPC call entails sending the arguments from the client to the server. And there is work to be done here, work to be done in sending the message, work to be done here before the server can actually execute the server procedure. So this is a latency that we are concerned about. And what we will see is all the software components that comprise the latency for RPC-based communication, and performance of RPC is very crucial in building client-server systems. There are two components to the latency that is observed for message communication in a distributed system. The first component is the hardware overhead, and the second component is the software overhead. The hardware overhead is really dependent on how the network is interfaced to the computer. So typically, in any computer, what you have is a network controller that interfaces the network to the CPU. And typically, the network controller operates by moving the bits of the message from the system memory of the node into its private buffer, which is inside the network controller. And this part of it, moving the bits from the memory of the node into the internal buffer of the network controller, is accomplished using what is called direct memory access, meaning the network controller is smart enough to move the bits directly using the bus that connects the memory to the network controller without the intervention of the CPU. And this is what is called direct memory access. And that's how the bits are moved from the memory of the system into the buffer of the network controller. And once it comes here, the network controller can then put the bits out on the wire, and this is where the bandwidth that you have connecting your node to the network comes into play. But there are also other types of network controllers where the CPU may actually be involved in the data movement, and in that case, the CPU does programmed I/O to move the bits from the memory into the buffer of the network controller, from which the network controller will then put it out on the network. But modern network controllers tend to be built using DMA technique, meaning that the network controller, once the CPU tells the network controller where in memory the message is to be sent on the wire, network controller does the rest in terms of moving the bits into its internal buffer and then from the buffer putting it out on the network. The software overhead is what the operating system tacks on to the hardware overhead of moving the bits out onto the network. So the latency, if you think about the latency as a whole for doing a network transmission, there is the software overhead incurred in the layers of the operating system to make the message available in the memory of the processor ready for transmission. Once it is ready for transmission, the hardware overhead kicks in, and the hardware, the network controller in particular, moves the bits from the memory into its buffer and then out on the wire. The focus, of course, being an operating system designer's work, is to reduce the software overhead and take what the hardware gives you and think about how you can reduce the software overhead so that we can overall reduce the latency involved in transmission, which is the sum of the hardware overhead and the software overhead.